in that tournament that I played too. Goddamn mofo.
Ugh. Ooh. Those sets though. Throw out of bed, huh? Doesn't like to fold to Z-bet too often. It's an interesting turn. I wonder, like, I think betting barreling this turn is probably a little bit too strong. I'm just not 100% sure what he's flatting this flop with. I feel like there's a lot of jacks in there. Yeah, let's check. What we do rip on him, though, is just, like, super strong. Yeah. It's a pretty big bet, though. I don't see him folding too often. Thing is, I don't have too many bluffs here where I just rip it in, but I just hope for the best, I guess. Nice! Bruh, full house early in the morn. Feels good, man. Gang, gang. Oh, scheisse. I don't think we really do anything other than just get it in. Hope for the best. Whoa, hole, please. Hole, please. Hole, please. Oh my goodness, I was freaking out there. He had a double gutter on the turn. That was quite the snap call, sir. That was very enthusiastic. Definitely going to bet. We don't need to bet huge, though. I think I should just be betting like with 100% my range here. And he'll have enough floats, especially when all we block is ace-king, which he would have probably 3-bet pre. Obviously not a great turn, because he has a decent amount of floats that are ace-x's. Okay, so I'll check. Interesting if he bets river. Just not 100% sure what he bluffs here. That's my problem right now. Yeah, I was thinking about finding a fold there. That sizing is just not bluffy, really. At least we flop a set to make ourselves feel better about life.
Let's fuck and then just talk about our feelings. You know what, man? After a good little session, I enjoy a good chat. I think that's what kept a couple of my girlfriends with me is like, we get it on, and then, you know, I'd be like, let's talk. As long as it's not 1 o'clock in the morning, you know, 1 o'clock in the morning, I'm just like, all right, roll over with my back turned and just pass out. If it's like 10 o'clock at night, we're done after a good little love making session. Let's just talk about life. Let's just share our feelings. It's pretty close, man. I think I gotta go for it. I'm not stoked on it though. We're flipping. Hold, please.
Hold, please. Just keep holding.
Nooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooooo
to call. We get there on the river. And I'm gonna raise call. This is pretty close. I'm in a call. He shoves. I think we'll probably ISO shove here and just try and win a flip.
Hopefully. Hopefully. Huh?
Oh. So close to winning two flips in a row. That was a tight one, though. That was a tight one. That felt good. That felt good, winning the flip there. This will be a call. This will be a call. You gotta be ahead of most of what he shoves here. Oh, not this time, though. Ooh, get there. Hold, please. Ooh. Oh, that makes me feel all nice and yummy inside. GG, sir. Motherfuckers never loved us. There it is. And we get a bounty, too. Feels good, man. I guess we'll just call, right? Not too worried about a heart, either. There it is. Hold my phone. Hold! Nice. That's a big one. Oh, crazy. Give you the silly bitch tag, sir. That squeeze, though. Although, was that... Oh, maybe he was just trying to ISO. Still, that squeeze was not good. That was not a good squeeze. With the bounty, even with the bounty. If you're gonna squeeze, squeeze bigger. Ooh, that is an action flop. Holy crap. We're gonna be an interesting spot, team. I think we got an ISO here. And if he shoves, I very reluctantly call. Well, we basically want a heads up, right? We don't want to flat give these guys a good price on a turn that we have to shut down on a lot. If we get check raised and a reshove, I might have to actually fold a set. Wow. Wow. Oh my god. This is my first hand of the tournament. Am I good enough to find a fold here? That is so sick. Oof. Oh. Can we all pat ourselves on the back here? Folded a set. That was so sick. That was so sick. Wow. That is, oh man, I could have gotten so much value there. Neuralux gives us the old 3-bet, huh? Well, this time we aren't folding to you, sir.
Hold, please. Hold, please. Keep holding.
Alex had something versus me too. He was getting in. Hi there. If you were 31 with a paid off condo, 500k in the bank, no kids, no job, what would you do with the rest of your life? That's a cool question. Man. That is a cool question. What did other people say? Travel the fucking world? Or two chicks at the same time? Watch Twitch poker all day? Or 2 years ago, and all I've done is play video games and watch Twitch. I honestly, man, in your situation, if I was in your shoes, I would basically go, what are things that slightly interest me? Even just an inkling, like, even if it was like, I want to learn this language, but kind of not really, I don't really care. You know, I would just go and just do it. See if you like it. What do you have to lose besides time that you've already wasted over the last 2 years just playing video games and watching Twitch? You know what I'm saying? I would just, like, for the most part, act on impulse, as long as it's healthy, of course. If, you know, don't be like, oh, I want to try cocaine and then develop cocaine habit. But like, oh, you know, I really wanted to, you know, I've always wanted to try fucking whatever, piano. Okay, I'll buy a decent keyboard and get myself some piano lessons. Like, just fill your day with shit, with cool stuff. That's what I would do. Have you ever wanted to start a business? This is a great opportunity. Start a really tiny small business. I would probably still keep working, honestly. I would just choose how much I want to work, you know, and leave that up to me, right? There's still so much room for growth in your life, right? Like, just because you retired and you have 500K, I don't think that means that you should just stop progressing productively, you know? Aces are nice in the small blind. Anybody want to shove? Anybody? Anybody? Anybody want a 3-bet or flat so I can rip it in a lot easier? I mean, I'm gonna get it in regardless. I think we just shove. Yeah, I'm just gonna shove here. I could 3-bet call. Yeah, let's 3-bet call. It's pretty, this is like super strong. I don't have really a bluffing range here at all, but let's try and get him to make mistakes. He's pretty loose so far. Get him to call too light in position. Okay, so I think we're just gonna make a bet call.
Hold, please.
Ugh. God damn, I played that so well. We set him up too, right? Get him to call too light. He wanted to call the jam either. Fuck. That's so sick. Run good, bro. Oh, what a cooler. I should have given him the fish tag too. That's just like way too light of a call. Fuck. But I just turned it off. Bro, I had him. Hook, line, and sinker and everything. God damn it. So sick. GG.
So we're gonna flat. I'll check call one street, continue on a jack of four, a spade, even a spade, there's a possibility I fold depending on what kind of sizing he gives me. But we're definitely gonna float, or we're definitely gonna flat flop. It makes a half pot bet, a little under half pot bet. Which I don't even know if he makes with the king, to be honest. Like, I think this is him bluffing more than value betting. So I'm gonna go ahead and call. We could very well be ahead here. Of course, if he barrels this turn, I'm not gonna guess. I'm just gonna give it to him and say nice hand. I'm just gonna take our time though. Just not really thinking about it. So if he checks, it gives me a free street. That'd be pretty awesome. Oh my god, that is a Craigasm river. Let's get some value, huh? I'm gonna bet pretty big here. He obviously has a lot of give ups, but he's also got a lot of hands that that will call to pretty close to any sizing, so just gotta think of the right sizing here and call a shove and just hope he doesn't have full house. So he's bluffing
on the snap overcall like a boss. Top pair is good. I think I'm gonna check call, keep his bluffs in. Make him overvalue, you know, jacks, tens, eights. What is that? I guess? I don't know. Oh my god. Hold, please. Oh my god.
You're a silly bitch, sir!
I'm gonna close the door, just so I can scream that stuff. Sir, you're a silly bitch. Why would you do such a thing ever? So I think we jam versus everybody. Yep. If he jams, I fold though. Bit of a tight jam, but or tight fold. Sorry, but I think it's fine. Now I'm rethinking things. Three bet versus steal, all in with ace five. Let's go for it. YOLO, 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 YOLO. Shows the ace.
Hold, please.
Oh! Oh my goodness, what a flop. What a flop. I almost folded there too. We were dominating. Oh my god. That is highlight reel worthy right there. To come my way. Okay, let's get double up with ace queen versus stupid mother. Can't think of a name because he's so bad. Oh boy, get me there.
Yo!
Oh! Goddamn jacks. First time he actually has a hand, we get some goddamn value and triple up. The hype! Gotta get this in. Blind versus blind. You of course call light, but we still have good equity. Yep, flipping.
Hold please. Hold please.
Nice! Double up. A double up! Yeah, this is a call. Flipping. Flips! Flips! Yeah! Got there! Yeah! GG, sir. Dig gods. And turn my hand into a bluff when he checks flop. Just get him to fold like sixes, sevens, nines, some 10x. Of course, he's gonna have queens sometimes that he checks back. Just, you know, makes my bluff even worse, but. Can't do nothing about it now, can I? You go ahead and lead big, bro, so I can get it in. There it is. Wham, bam, thank you, ma'am. Even with the full, with the trips, you're no good, sir. Ooh, that was a big one. That was a big one. I'm gonna definitely highlight reel my bad bluff, too. I think it's good to sometimes put in that bad bluff with the 7-8. It wasn't great. I should just check give up on the turn.
He checked flop on the queen 3-3 or whatever, and I bet a brick turn and barreled a brick river, and I think I should just completely shut down. It's good in a highlight reel to also throw in some mistakes, you know? Nobody's perfect. Okay, so we definitely defend. Open ender. I'm curious about ripping here and just putting pressure on him.
When there's such a short stack behind, just getting him to fold like ace queen and jack x.
I'm gonna throw that out. See what he does here. You'll call with a jack for one street, but we can barrel him off on the river quite a lot. And that's a pretty good river. We don't block clubs, which sucks. I think he c-bets backdoor clubs as well as club draws on the flop pretty often though. So we're gonna throw out like a value heavy looking bet, give him to fold all of his one pair combos and weak pairs. I don't know if this is the right bet. Maybe I should bet bigger actually. Nice. I gotta look at that sizing though, because I still don't think that sizing's proper. Like, yeah, it worked, but I don't think that sizing's correct. Ooh. Oh shit. Ooh. Aces. Oh, crazy. Let's do it, baby. Let's do it. Hold, please. Hold, please. Keep on. Nice. No 10 on the river. GG, sir. GG, what a good time to have aces. Oh. Alright, we are four-handed, just like that. That's actually not a bad flop for me. I think we can bet here. Trying to do some bluffs. If you check shoves, I'll probably call. And I'll check turn and call bet on the river. No overcards would be nice. Go call a jack or a queen. Great river. He's gonna bluff this 100%. All right, well, good luck. Let's see if I'm right. Yep, was right, brah. I think this is a pretty good spot for me to go ahead and c-bet as well. You can just kind of keep betting these small sizings. Kind of wonder about betting bigger sizings. I don't think it's necessary. Part of me wants to bet like half. It's interesting if you check raises, what you want. Great turn card for me to bet quite a bit bigger. And we'll barrel really hard on the river. Party poker sounds like a great idea. 8882. Yeah. Those are all the spots that I'm gonna work on towards the next. Oh, Bink. Well, I was gonna bet big on the river regardless, so I guess we'll just go for it, right? Oh boy, this is some silly shit. If he's got ace five, he's gonna be really upset. Run good, DD. Can we run good to get him to flat? I was gonna bet the sizing, even if it was a brick, like a six or something. I was gonna bet the sizing. I was even gonna turn like a queen into a bluff. Oh, he's gonna go for it. The hero call, it's coming. I feel it. I feel it, bro. Yeah, run good, DD. Oh, what'd you have, dude? Jack 10. Oh, he rivered two pair. Yeah. Oh, should have overbet shoved, man. That's some run good. Run good. What was it talking about? Oh, yeah.
But over here, checked flop. Set on the turn. Off to work. Hugs and yes, good luck. Thanks, Matt. Have fun at work. So I guess we bet now, right? I think we can actually bet fairly large. If the game folds a king or a 10. All right, bro. Not stoked on it though. Oh, stoked on it now. Ooh. Nice pot size bet on the river there, bruh. That's nice.
Get him to jam. Get him to jam. You jam. You jam that bitch. Oh, sigh when these guys make these calls.
I mean, the fortunate thing is that, like, he just doesn't smash this flop. I think we just got to put that pressure on him, and when he shoves, then we'll just kind of side call. Eh, gross. All right, let's see if we can get there. Sevens, of course. Terrible. Terrible, man. Terrible. But it's a terrible call by me, too, you know? I should probably just bet fold. I should probably, like... That's a big... A big, big mistake. I should just bet fold. Like, bet 4K and fold to a jam. What can you do, man? Well, you can fold. You can fucking fold, Dare Trav. Fucking hell. I'm a little tilted with myself that I gave away that many chips. That's, you know, that can cost me the tournament in the long run, you know? You can definitely put the talk points in the chat. Urgh. So mad. Okay. Oh, poker staples. Oh my God. Bro, you're distracting me. Oh my goodness. Oh my goodness. Dropping a host. That is a baller host. Oh my goodness. 9 month resub. Good luck, dude. Mr. Poker Staples. That is a big boy host, man. Holy crap. Let's just concentrate on the task at hand here. Mr. DGen. And now I think I just check call. Use this as a bluff catcher, I think. Keep his 6x in, some low pocket pairs maybe. He's just not floating a ton. Oh shit, he's actually got... God, the goddamn host distracted me. Oh my goodness. It just caught me off guard. Thank you, Jamie. Thanks, buddy. So we'll check. Pot control. A lot of good turn cards for us too, right? If he bets, it's pretty standard, pretty easy call. I just can't see a, like, I just don't understand why he wouldn't c-bet here with top pair, like, for value. So I'm having a hard time believing this bet on the turn unless he's got 8-9 basically. And now we've got what, the third nuts? Is that right? Yeah, third nuts. Nice bluff, dude. Nice bluff, dude. You silly motherfucker. Oh, you so silly. You still get a caller, huh? You call, sir. Pretty dry ass flop, though. I guess we'll check. Bet turn. I don't think we'll be stacking off. Please, no three, no ace on the river, please. I have the spade blocker, so that's good. We want to keep some of those bluffs in, though. Easy call. Oh! It's like the only thing I'm worried about is a set. Creeps! Quads. Okay, let's get some value here, huh? He calls every pair, right? I wonder, is this too ambitious? Might be too ambitious. Oh, we got it. Oh, we got it. Wowza, the snap shove. Oh, he's Brazilian. I think we're ahead here.
Hold, please. Hold, please. Hold.
Nice. That was a big one. That was a big one. Goddamn Brazilian, dude. That snap shove is rarely nutted, I'll tell you that much right now. Oh boy, on the bubble with aces. We're only one big blind ahead of 15th place. Don't do it, Sasanga. Don't do it, Sasanga. Oh, Sasanga. He folded aces pre. He did it. He folded aces pre on the seat bubble to the satellite. It was hard. It hurt. My testicles retracted into my body. What? What the fuck? What the fuck? No way, dude. Everybody hates the fold with aces. Dude, always fold aces pre. Okay, guys, just do yourselves a favor and always fold aces pre, no matter what. That's funny. Probably float one street. A lot of good turn cards to bluff too. A 6, a 9, a 10, a 4. All good bluff cards, just because, like, we have all the hands that turn a straight, whereas he doesn't really. And we, of course, do have our overcards, our backdoor flush draw as well. So I really don't mind floating here, especially with the price you just gave me. So if he checks, we definitely bet. He checks here pretty often, right? So I'm going to go ahead and bluff this.
Ah, that's such a shit river when he snap calls like this too. I mean, we block jacks and aces, so there's kings and queens, but I think he's also got a lot of ace high floats and flush draws here. Maybe just get him to fold on the river. Or we're out, second hand in. Oh, queen 10! How dare you! Karma, DD, you're such a donk, DD. Can we get DD, you're a donk fish in the chat, please? Oh, Bankerino. And good luck, us. Do we beat him too? Yeah, we take a bounty as well when we win. GetDara.com. Bam. Run good, DD. Run good, you goddamn gooba. Oh. That's nice.
Guess we just check call, right?
And then probably check shove turn. Please, no club on the turn. Please. Actually, you know what? I think I like check calling and then shoving river. Oh, baby. He would have called on the turn anyway, but still. Feels good, man. Oh, that's a nice hand right there. Off call. Bounties, baby. Okay, calm down. Probably has like ace four. Called it. Dude, I called it. I fucking called it. So we're given 2-1 plus two, one decent bounty, one very large bounty. So I'm gonna call this off. 20%, runner. 9 or 6. Oh, bink. That's why bounty builders are so crazy. So that's the only situation I would ever call there. It's because it's a bounty builder. Dude, this guy has a massive bounty. We're going for it. Fuck it, dude. If you're shoving with jacks, you're a fish, and you're getting paid off, you're welcome. I'm going for that bounty, baby. Oh! Oh, shit! Ah! Dude. That's how you win MTTs, I'm pretty sure. Ooh, straight flush got there. That's okay, we're gonna river quads versus his flush. Not straight flush, straight flush still wins. Dude, I called quads. I said we're gonna get quads and we got quads. Dude, if this guy has a straight flush. He's bluffing. But dude, I called quads and we rivered quads. The highlight reel, no. This was the time that we had to put the mask on for the sound delay issues. Give me that double up. There it is. There it is. Good luck, team. FD Hustler, don't forget him, DD. Oh, man. I haven't heard that name in a long time. FD Hustler, that's funny. Get there. Get there on the river. GG. 65, 63 in bounties. Okay, guys. See you guys later. Bye-bye. Mwah! Love y'all. Peace.